In previous videos, I released a very high-quality digital human vlog. We can take a look. When we analyze the technical details, in addition to the workflow, a very important part is LoRA. LoRA is excellent at maintaining character consistency. Let's look at another example. This is a one-shot video. This one is even more dramatic, because the entire story is completed within the same scene. To achieve such a video, the most crucial part is also LoRA. Today, we will explain in detail the Wan2.1 LoRA training process. The method we are teaching you today to train this LoRA is quite unique. We directly train images instead of videos. Therefore, its training speed is very fast. If we want to train a perfect LoRA, there are roughly three stages. First, dataset preparation. Second, training task. Construction. Third, result, validation. Okay, let's start from the beginning. First, let's talk about dataset preparation. Today, the LoRA we are training is called Glasses Woman, which is a girl wearing glasses. The original dataset for this actually comes from a workflow I released in a previous video, which is called Flux Context High Precision Face Swapping Workflow. You can see the works I generated using this workflow. The quality is very high. To make it clear for everyone, let's run one now. Okay, this workflow has finished running. Our general idea here is this. The overall workflow is a flux context workflow. Crucially, within this, we used a LoRA called Placeit. What you are seeing now is the link to this LoRA on Hugging Face. What is its function? It's for image blending. Currently, our original image is this one. We pasted this face onto another character. By using this LoRA, we can perfectly blend this face with this character. Take a look at the effect. And its trigger word is only Placeit. The most crucial part of this workflow is actually how this image is generated. Many popular creators manually paste faces, but mine is automatically generated. Because I used an entire video to explain this workflow, we'll keep it brief here. Using this method, we can generate a large dataset of the same character. Okay, next, let's talk about a very important step. Dataset filtering. Take a look at these 10 images I selected. For these 10 images, we need to pay attention to a few points. The first is character consistency. You need to ensure that the character is indeed the same person. The second very important thing is to pay attention to their hairstyle. We try our best to keep it consistent, because if you have different hairstyles, we would have to treat them differently when writing prompt words. Therefore, for initial practice, I do not recommend increasing the difficulty too much. Another point is that you need to ensure your images include multiple angles. As for the resolution, you can make it 768 or 1024. Even if you use different resolutions, it's fine. However, to ensure overall quality, we recommend making the images square. This way, during subsequent training, when you see the intermediate validation results, the images won't be distorted. This concludes the section on dataset post-processing. Okay, next, let's look at the actual training. Today, the tool we are using is still AI-Toolkit. Regarding the choice of training tools, different people may have different needs. When I explain it, I mainly focus on ease of use. This AI-Toolkit has a UI interface, making it very easy to operate. Furthermore, this repository has a very large number of stars, currently reaching 5,600. It currently supports Quen Image Wan 2.2. All of these are supported. However, we are currently doing a 2.1 training, so regarding versions, you don't need to worry too much. Next, let's briefly talk about its installation. Its installation is relatively simple, whether on Windows or Linux. It's generally divided into a few steps. First, clone the repository. Then, create a virtual environment. And most importantly, we need to install PyTorch. The current required version is 2.7, along with corresponding Torch Vision and Torch Vision. And TorchShodio. On Windows, it's basically a similar command combination. Finally, just install the necessary extension packages. Regarding the installation part, I have a very detailed description in this video. If you are unclear, you can refer to the latter half of this video. Regarding the hardware requirements for training 1.2.1 LoRA, we need to clarify that if you use AI Toolkit, the VRM size should be around 30 gigabytes. Everyone should try to choose a 48 gigabytes graphics card. Therefore, personal consumer grade graphics cards might not be sufficient. Once you have successfully deployed AI Toolkit, we can then start it. The method of starting it is clearly explained on its official website. Let's look at the important part. We need to enter the UI directory within AI Toolkit and then run a specific command. If you want to add a password, because you don't want everyone to be able to log into your terminal, right? So, we can use the method below to set your super password and then start the service. Once it's started, you need to note that the port it listens on is 8675. Okay, let's try it now. I am currently on a Linux platform, and I have already activated my virtual environment. Next, we enter the AI Toolkit directory, then the UI directory, and then we'll set a super password. I set the password to Ganlos, then we press enter. Okay, it has now finished starting. You should see this information. Please note that this address is an internal network address. We need to use an external network address. If you are deploying locally, this doesn't matter. But if you are deploying on the cloud, you must use its external network address. Let's copy it. The default port is 8675. Since I have already entered the password, I can directly access it. The first step is to upload our dataset. Please note, I have already uploaded it for you here. If you don't have it, you can use the dataset construction method we just discussed to upload it. Please note, my current prompt words are very simple and all the same. Called Glasses Woman. Next, everyone needs to do something. We need to fill in your Hugging Face access token in the settings. Because it requires this access token when downloading models. How do you obtain this? Let's briefly explain. First, you need to go to Hugging Face. Then register and log in. After that, go to your personal homepage. You need to click on your avatar. Then click on Access Tokens. You can then enter the page for setting access tokens. If it's your first time, you'll need to enter your password to proceed, to ensure its security. Creating a token is very simple. Just create one. Everyone can choose read permission, then give it a name, and click create. Please note, after creation, remember to save it, because the full token is only visible at the time of creation. Once it's created, if you look again, it will appear like this, and you won't be able to see the full token. This is similar to many platforms. Then just copy it and save it here. After saving, you must click Save Settings. Otherwise, it won't take effect, right? Our dataset is ready. The access token is configured. Next, let's create the training task. We just click New Job. You can name it anything. For example, I'll call it Glasses Woman V. Please note that we don't need a trigger word because I have already written the prompt words in this dataset. Also, everyone, take a look. Which model do you want to use? Here we are using 1.2.114 BT2V, so select this one. You can keep the other settings as default. For the training parameters below, you can also mostly keep them as default. The crucial part here is that you must select Sigmoid. This significantly boosts our training speed. Further down, for the dataset, we select Glasses Woman. For resolution, we choose 512, 768, and 1024. Below that is the sample configuration. Sample refers to how often a sample is taken, which is essentially our validation to see how well the generation is performing. Because visual generation, unlike classification or other model training, doesn't have a clear metric, we can only visually assess whether it meets your requirements. Please note, we perform validation every 250 rounds. Because your total training steps are 3,000 steps, we sample every 250 steps to check the intermediate generation effects. Although we are training a video here, we will use an image training method, so set number frames to 1. For width and height, we use 1024 by 1024. Then we need to set the prompt words. During validation, these prompt words will be used to generate images. There are some examples here that basically cover some common scenarios, but everyone needs to modify them slightly. For example, the trigger word I use is Glasses Woman. This needs to be consistent with our dataset. Take a look at Glasses Woman. So, here it is, also Glasses Woman. Below this is a horse. If you don't want it, delete it. This is a man, If you find it hard to modify, you can also delete it. This is a bear. Delete it. This is still a woman, so let's change it back to glasses woman. And this is a man with a beard. Let's just delete that too. Although this is a man, it's fine, because it just says white background. So here, we'll directly change it. We'll also change this to a person holding a sign with text on it. Below is a dog. We'll delete that too. So, we'll keep about 5 images. I think 5 images are enough. Then, we click Create Job. After that, we start running it. The rest is a completely idiot-proof process. First, it will download the model. Since my model is already downloaded, you might not see this process. If you set up the AI toolkit yourself, downloading the model will take a long time, possibly due to poor network conditions or cloud environment. This will cause slow downloads. Now, it's directly starting to load the model. Let's see. This model, ... you should note, is divided into 12 parts. So you'll see a total of 12. It's starting to load. Further down, we need to load our encoder. The encoder is divided into 5 parts in total. Let's wait a moment. Let's see. Now, the encoder has also finished loading. The VE loads very quickly. Then, it starts preparing the model. Next, we will perform the first step of sampling, which is called baseline sampling. This is a sample taken before training, without any LoRA added, meaning the model directly generates original images based on your prompt words. We set 5 prompt words in the task. Therefore, you will find that each image will go through 25 sampling steps, and then they will be generated one by one. Let's wait a moment. Okay, everyone, take a look. The initial sampling is complete. Let's examine the first step of sampling. These are the images generated by the model using the original prompt words. Below, the training process will begin. Everyone, look, the speed is quite fast. It has now trained for 17 steps. At 250 steps, the second sampling will occur. At this point, LoRA will be involved. So, I will temporarily stop it and show you a complete 3,000-step process that I have already trained. Let's directly look at the sampling results. This is the same as what I just showed you. Then, in the second step, the character I wanted starts to appear and becomes increasingly similar. The facial features are emphasized. Everyone can see. Then, the surrounding environment gradually becomes more detailed, right until the end of our training. Finally, everyone can just download the model. When you click on this task, the models you recently trained are all listed here. A total of 5. You can download whichever one you need. Generally, we just download the last one. Download it, and then we move on to our testing phase. The workflow I use for validation is our vlog generation workflow, which you can find in my published workflows. Look at the generated effect. It's excellent, right? Of course, you can also use different prompt words for testing. Generating these prompt words also requires some skill. If you want to achieve beautiful images and good lighting, prompt words are indispensable. Therefore, as we mentioned in the vlog video, the prompt word generator is also a very important part. We will also have a separate video to explain this. So, this is the 1.2 LoRA training process we discussed today. You can follow this video to generate your own LoRA and then conduct corresponding tests. Okay, that's all for today. Follow me to become an AI savvy person.